have always obeyed. Not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence. Work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. And that's important, that you work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. That fear and trembling is what's gonna keep you in line. That fear and trembling is what's gonna have you dedicated to the word of Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai. That fear and trembling is what's gonna cause you to get disciplined and be disciplined by this word. That fear and trembling. Right, you see guys at the shooting range because they have no fear of Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai, and they are not trembling. You see guys putting videos together about getting married, you know, having marriages to these Babylonian women, cooking hamburgers and fringes and all this because they have no fear of Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai, and they are not trembling. But we were commanded to work out our own salvation with fear and trembling. So it's the time that we are living in. Deliver every man his own soul, if it be the will of Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai, Abba Ritaz. So yeah, man, that's the point in that. But now much more in my absence, it say work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. So with that, going back to Jeremiah 51:6, flee out of the midst of Babylon and deliver every man his soul. Be not cut off in her iniquity, for this is the time of the Most High's vengeance. He will render unto her a recompense. We are living in the time of Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai's vengeance. He's getting ready to send his only begotten son back with the host of heaven to bring vengeance to Babylon and the wicked worldwide. If you knew that and you really understood that, then you would be doing everything in your power to get right with Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai. You would be working out your own salvation with fear and with trembling. You would be keeping these laws, statutes, and commandments to the very best of your ability. Giving your all for the sake of Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai and the preaching of this gospel and the testimony of Yahweh Shai. Giving your all to stand in this truth, to stand in faith. You got a lot of pretenders, a lot of fakers, a lot of imposters claiming to be Hebrew Israelites. You got a lot of people out here that, you know, actually false flaggers in this truth. False flaggers. They claim one thing, but they really are, you know, something else. So, hey, man, we're in the time of sifting. We're in the time of sifting, so you see guys fall out this truth is because they never were a part of this truth. But anyway, yeah, that was the point on that, flee ye out of the midst of Babylon. You understand? So, yeah, that was it on, also in Micah. Arise ye and depart, because this is not our rest. We were brought here to serve slavery, as I was saying. We were brought here as slaves to serve this so-called white man. But now it's his turn. He's about to be brought into captivity under the nation of Israel. Thus said the scriptures. So I'm gonna go to the book of Deuteronomy. Of course, America's gonna be destroyed. So get ready for destruction to come to America. America's already in decline. The economy is folding. Trump is about to take you into World War III, and y'all gonna end up in slavery. Thus said the scriptures. Thus said the Most High. Hey, America's gonna be destroyed. Y'all better repent. Come back to the laws, statutes, and commandments of the Bible. Yeah, Yeah, so for you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, y'all have a place of repentance. Like I said, this is a platform where you can come and learn about your heritage. And if it be the will of the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, then you might, you know, can receive that repentance or receive that salvation. I put it like that. You know, anybody can repent, but only the elect are going to remain, you know. Some people are going to repent and endure for a little while, but then they'll eventually fall off. But the elect are going to endure until the end. Anybody can repent, but only the elect are going to be delivered. So, right, this is, I'm out here for the elect of you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. And for the rest of you people out here, man, I just got a message for you that, you know, America's going to be destroyed, and y'all are going into captivity. If you're not a Hebrew Israelite, you are going into captivity. Thus said Yahweh, by Hashem Yahweh Shah. Whether you were here or whether you forbear, I could give a care less. You know, I'm sanctioned to come out here and tell you the truth of the Holy Scriptures. So I'm going to bring this out, just get straight to the point, man. Get straight to the point. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68. And Yahweh shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships, by the way whereof I speak unto thee, or I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again. And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies, for bondmen and bondwomen, and no man shall buy you. So, you know, please understand it. Because this scripture has, it says a lot, just this one scripture. There's a lot of meat on this one scripture. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again. That word Egypt means to bind. So the Lord did bring us back into bondage again. Where? Right here in Americas, under this goddamn white man. So we were brought into Egypt again by way of ships, these cargo slave ships. There's no denying that. That's a part of history. Well-documented history. And to deny that, that would make you a fool. You understand? So again, and Yahweh shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships, by the way whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again. Right, we will see the nation, the land of Israel no more again. You know? Because even if a nigga was to pack up and go to Israel, that's not the Israel we left. Those gutter rats over there changed everything about our land. That's why it must be born. That's why the Heavenly Father will make sure some ICBMs go that way. To cleanse them gutter rats and them goddamn, not only them so-called Israelis, but them Palestinians so-called also. They all getting off our land. By way of thermonuclear fire, the Most High is gonna cleanse and purge that land with thermonuclear fire. Thus said the scripture. So understand that, even if you was to go back to Israel, that's not the place that we left. That's not the land that we left. The land that we left, man, is gonna be even greater when we get there. When we go back to our homeland, Israel, it's gonna be as the Garden of Eden, as it should be. Them goddamn gutter rats over there, the so-called Jews, they gonna have to un-ass our land and our heritage. They've been perpetrating a fraud, you know, across the whole world, telling the whole world that they are the Israelites. But the true Israelites are you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. Y'all are the true nation of Israel. So right, hey, the Heavenly Father about to send Yahweh Shah back to rectify this shit, man. Rightfully so. You white people have reigned and ruled in wickedness for far too long. Y'all destroyed the earth, you're destroying the animals, there's so many endangered species, it doesn't make any sense. And y'all about to make the Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans an endangered species. if the Lord don't come back soon. Y'all about to make us an endangered species. Again, according to the scripture. The Lord said if he don't come back soon, there won't be no flesh left to be saved. So this so-called white man must be taken out of the way. He must be taken out of rulership before he destroy the world and everyone in it. He doesn't know how to rule. And just like I said, what problem has he solved since he's been in office? Or in rulership, not office, but since this so-called white man been in power, what issues has he solved? Everything is up. Unemployment is up. He can't solve the issue of unemployment. So with unemployment being up, homelessness is up. The rate of disease among you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans is up. Now this so-called white man, you know, he's supposed to know everything. Y'all run to him for every little thing, talking about you Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. As soon as you get a little cough, you run into this goddamn white man. When the Heavenly Father got the apostles out here and the men under them telling you about the herbs, we enlighten you and educating you on the herbs, natural medication, first and foremost, even before we go to the herbs, Leviticus, the 11th chapter. If you would follow Leviticus, the 11th chapter, a lot of your ailments would go away. You Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans would drink more water. Clean, good water. A lot of your issues would go away. Y'all want to quick to run to goddamn dialysis and shit because the white man tell you got kidney failure, or quick to get on some insulin because this goddamn white man tell you you're a diabetic, when there's natural ways to get your blood sugar regulated. Drinking water, even if, you know, unless you got, you know, terminal kidney damage, or to an extreme, kidney damage to the extreme. A lot of ailments with the kidneys can clear up with just drinking clean, clear water. Following the proper diet. So right, hey, we out here to tell you this, but hey, only the men who the Most High set up are gonna listen. This is for the wise. And in the last days, the Most High is making known who are the wise. You know, but y'all quick to run to this white man is my point that I was making. Y'all quick to run to this white man as if he's an authority on anything. But if he's so much of an authority, why is the world in the shape that it's in? Because this man is the goddamn devil. How many times we have to tell y'all this? But all people trust and admire and love this white man with a passion. Y'all love this white man more than you love Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah. That's why y'all cling on to that picture of white Jesus and your Jesus pieces. Because y'all love the white man. In essence, at the end of the day, you don't love the Heavenly Father and his only begotten Son. You love this white man. That's who you really love. That's who you really love. Two-thirds of you Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. Y'all have an ongoing love affair with this goddamn white man that has been unprofitable to you in every way imaginable and has produced nothing but misery, pain, injury for you. But yet you won't let this devil go. You won't let him go. He's done nothing for you Negroes, neither you Latinos, nor you so-called Native Americans, nothing. But yet, you know, yeah, but yet, you know, y'all still, hey, y'all can't give him up. Y'all like a junkie, you know, y'all need y'all fix. You need your Edomite fix. Y'all can't live without this so-called white man. You know, y'all love everything about this devil. Y'all want to dress like him. You want to talk like him. You want to follow his religions and stuff. You got niggas, man. Niggas getting to Scientology, namely Will Smith. Nigga wants to be a Scientologist. Hey man, our people in bad shape out here. Our people in bad case out here in this world, man. We need Yahweh Ba'al Shem Yahweh Shah like never before. You know? So yeah, with that, going back to Deuteronomy. Again, 28 and verse 68. What's up, man?
Good, how are you?
All right. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships, by the way whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again. And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies for bondmen and bondwomen, and no man shall buy you. Right, so we are sold for, you know, here in America. Babylon the Great, the virgin daughter of Babylon the Great. We are sold to our enemies for bond men and bond women. Not sold to our friends, not sold to our, any associates of ours. We are sold unto our enemies for bond men and bond women. So it says, and no man shall buy you. Right, no man's gonna save you. No man's able to save you from, you know, the clutches of this goddamn white man. And that is flesh and blood, man. You know? It's like, you know, Marcus Garvey, he wasn't able to deliver you Negroes. Neither other you Israelites for that matter. Neither was the dishonorable Elijah Muhammad. Neither Malcolm X, any of these other guys, Martin Luther King, any of these other guys, no man has been able to buy you. Why? Because that was set up strictly for Yahweh Shah. And when he comes back, he's not coming back as a man. So yeah, man, we over here in slavery. Still to this day, serving this goddamn white man. Because Yahweh Shah hasn't come back yet. If the scriptures say no man shall buy you, and you know Yahweh Shah hadn't come back yet, that means we are still yet this day in our captivity. Maybe you thought, you know, maybe you thought Abraham Lincoln delivered you Negroes. Because that's what a lot of you believe. A lot of you believe that Abraham Lincoln freed you niggas. Through the 13th, 14th Amendment. But just do your homework. Just do your homework on that. Emancipation Proclamation means just that. It was a proclaiming that you Negroes would be emancipated. Now, all you need to do is just look up the term emancipate. And it means to take from the hand. Eman go back to manus, which means hand, and kapara mean to take. So when you talk about emancipation, you're talking about to take from the hand. So in essence, what happened, that was the Emancipation Proclamation was a proclaiming that we would be taken from the hands of those southern sovereign Edomites, those slave owners, taken from their hands and given it to the banking elite. And now today you're under all these different contracts because you belong to these bankers. You Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans work just as hard today, if not more than what you did back in when we were picking cotton. I know I done put in my share of 12 and 15 hour days. I know I done it. I know plenty of others that done it. You know, I did, you know, all manual labor, man. I did some, I used to make bricks, stack bricks, all day long, man, no